Currently, the budget allocation of UPDF stands at 417.6 billion shillings, and 517 billion shillings is required in the next financial year. But for the force to implement the UPDF enhanced salary structure that was approved by the Ministry of Public Service in 2017, 2.01 trillion shillings is required.
Payment of the salaries of soldiers that has been approved by public service, and it is within that target that the ministry is allocating the payment in phases, because we cannot say that we are going to pay all that amount of money within one financial year. So it is that percentage that the Ministry of Defence will come back and explain to us in the way that they have distributed the payment among the different ranks.
In the enhanced structure, the CDF salary is to rise from 2 million to 20 million shillings, generals from 2 million to 18.8 million, lieutenant general from 1.87 million to 17.7 million, major general from 1.69 million to 15.8 million, and brigadier general from 1.5 million to 13.9 million. The increment is to spell down to the lowest rank of local defense personnel, which is to rise from 183,400 shillings to 850,000 shillings, and privates from 385,279 shillings to 1.29 million shillings.
I want the members to understand the situation we were in, because this negotiation also was not very easy.
Yes.
You can imagine moving all along, you are the leaders in those areas. Your generals have been getting 2 million. So you can see really the fight we. So when we said deputy CDF, they said we don't have deputy PS. So we said, okay. When you win something, you say, okay, the little meat you get, let me get it first. Then I will complain later. But all of this came, and I want to assure the member that we really pleaded for the deputy CDF. They said, no, for us, we are using PS. We don't have deputy PS. Now you go, these are your generals, use your ranks.
PDF have had their salaries enhanced to a very reasonable level, and we are glad that has happened. But our concern as members of the committee are that the lower ranking officers, the privates, the corporals, the corporals have not been adequately provided for in the proposals for 2023-2024.
I'm not convinced the way all the criteria they used when trying to increase the salaries across the board, and who should come first and who should come last.
MPs called for fairness in distribution of salary enhancements, especially for the lower ranking officers, and vowed to summon the permanent secretary of the Ministry of Public Service to explain the criteria that was used and ensure that the LDPs and privates are equally allotted a reasonable pay rise.
As a committee, we are interested in the lower ranks that have been getting low money, like LDPs, 200,000. And this is the person who is working. So those are some of the things that where we want the members of parliament to support, particularly with some slight increment on the enhancement of the lower ranks, the private, all those that have not been considered.
In the UPDF in this modern era, 21st century, that still has issues to do with the KATEBE. Anywhere in the region, you don't find.
What is KATEBE?
KATEBE is where someone is having a land, he has no work to do. Literally, the public service, that would be someone on almost making disciplinary action. Who was supposed even to pay a half salary? But here, we are providing generals who are in that category money more than what is someone who is working day and night. Take, for example, a land commander. This is working day and night. And there is somebody who has somehow disciplinary related issue seated at home on the KATEBE and is having more money than somebody who's busy working as a commander and posting.
In the same meeting with the Committee of Defense, the Defense Minister, Vincent Sempija, disclosed that UPDF has so far killed 426 ADF rebels in the joint Operation Shujaa in 2022 alone. 18 ADF rebels have been captured, 115 abductees rescued, and 118 firearms recovered.
So the joint forces continue to mount pressure against ADF elements in order to decisively neutralize the group.
The minister has told us about the deaths, the terrorists which have been put out of the action, but has not told us what about our boys there. How many have been put out of action? How many have been injured? Because at the end of the day, we need to look after them.
UPDF now seeks 21.4 billion shillings to sustain Operation Shujaa in 2023 to 2024 financial year, 6.9 billion being for food, 5.4 billion for fuel, 2.1 billion for lubricants, 625.4 million for maintenance, 400.2 billion for medical fees, and 2.03 billion for travels inland. Meanwhile, the Uganda People's Defense Forces has vowed to end ADF rebel activity in Uganda and the Democratic Republic of Congo.
It's a matter of time. Most of these ADF guys will come out or will be eliminated if they don't come out.
And when you look at the history of this country, indeed, this is a memorable day. Because we all know at one time, people in this country would take off, run in the opposite direction whenever they used to meet.
In November 2021, the Uganda People's Defense Forces, with the blessing of Kinshasa, launched a joint operation against the ADF. The armed group stood accused of carrying out suicide bombings that claimed three lives and left scores injured in Uganda. Story by Fred Kajubi and John Antusingire for the news.